Hey everyone, it's Katie and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. So you can subscribe, the button is always down below. Post video, lifestyle planning and more. So today's video is one I have been kind of like forgetting, kind of procrastinating to do like pretty much all year. These are usually videos that I do in January, but for whatever reason this year I just didn't do it until now, like literally 9 months into the year. Good job, Katie. But this is gonna be my Sephora loves list for 2021 and stuff. I feel like one of the reasons why I kind of procrastinated it is because I felt like in the beginning of the year I didn't have that much on my loves list, but I always like doing like a yearly loves list showing you what's on kind of my like Sephora wish list and stuff. And I'm really excited about this. I feel like I have a decent amount of things on here that I want to talk about. So yeah, let's just go ahead and get right into it. Also, if you can hear like a lawnmower of sorts coming in and out, it's because one of my neighbors, I'm pretty sure, is mowing their lawn. Obviously, if you hear a lawnmower, that's what it is, Katie, like clearly. So let's just disregard that and talk about my loves. So the first thing I literally just added because it's like a new product, and this is the Rare Beauty by Selena Gomez Mini Strokes Universal Volumizing Mascara. I just have the mini on here because I prefer to like try out mascaras in minis. Honestly, I even prefer like buying high-end mascaras in minis compared to full sizes because I feel like it's hard to go through a full mascara in like 3 to 6 months before it expires, especially if you're using multiple mascaras like me, because I'm a mascara like lover. It's like one of my things I love trying out. But this one looks really interesting, and I really like the brand Rare Beauty. Like, I think it's a really nice brand. I don't know, like I just really like it. And I've also been like a Selena Gomez fan for like life practically, so pretty much every Rare Beauty product is always on my wish list. So next thing that's on my loves list is the Bite Beauty Power Move Hydrating Soft Matte Lipstick and Sugar Buns. This is like a pink nude. So my all-time favorite Bite Beauty lipstick was Honeycomb. I used the whole thing up. It was my favorite nude, one of two favorite nudes ever and stuff. And then they reformulated the lipsticks and then changed the names. I don't know if they just changed the names or if they changed the colors as well with when they were reformulated, but I really want to try the new formula. But I also just really want to see if this is comparable to Honeycomb. I just really want to know. So I'm hoping it is, because that was my favorite nude. Like I said, like all time go to holy grail nude. Yeah, I want to see if this is comparable because I love it. And the next thing I have on there is the Makeup by Mario Soft Pop Blush Stick. I've been really into like cream blushes recently. Have been using a ton, like Rare Beauty, e.l.f., like the practically all of them I've been trying, and this one has been out of stock for a while. I know a lot of his stuff has been going in and out of stock, so hopefully they'll come in stock eventually. I mean, I really just want to try Makeup by Mario's products like everyone else, so hopefully they'll come back in stock. The next day I have quite a few items from Selfless by Hyram. I love Hyram. His skincare videos, like I feel like during 2020 I discovered him through like TikTok, and then I started following him on YouTube, and I love, like I feel like I've gotten a lot of skincare like tips from him that have like honestly improved my skincare, which I want to do an updated skincare routine, and I'm currently trying to work on that and, you know, figure out, you know, that whole spiel, but that's beside the point. But I have quite a few of his products on my wish list. So the first one is the Retinol Rainbow Algae Repair Serum and stuff. I really want to like get into like retinols, so this is on my list. And I know his products are pricey, but they're also like supposed to be environmentally friendly packaging, and I think it's supposed to be like biodegradable or something. I don't even know, but I've had that on my wish list because I think it would be, I don't know, I just want to try a retinol, and I've tried products that have some type of retinol in them before and they've worked really well for my skin, so that's definitely on my wish list. And then I also have his Niacinamide and Maracuja Daily Support Moisturizer on my wish list. This one I might honestly just buy for myself. My birthday is literally coming up when I'm filming this. I don't know when this video is going up, but when I'm filming this, my birthday is like 11 days away. So I might honestly pick up my birthday gift online and then pick up the this moisturizer because I really have been wanting to try it for a while and stuff. And honestly, any Hyrum products I really want to try, to be honest with you. Like, I'm just really intrigued. And I love niacinamide products, so I would love that. So next I have a couple Tower 28 glosses. I know a lot of people rave about these, so I've kind of put like a few Tower 28 products onto my wish list. The first one is their Shine On Jelly Gloss and Fearless, which is a sheer berry. I don't know why I put this on my wish list, but I just really was intrigued. So that's on my wish list. And then I also have the shade Oat, which is a milky peachy pink. It just looks like a nice like nude. I think it was like the lightest color, so I was like, okay, nice new gloss. I love new glosses. Those are like my favorites, and I really want to try this brand. I also know they have like cream blushes too, and I'm kind of intrigued with those. I just don't have any on my loves list and stuff. That's just not something I put on my loves list, but I'm definitely intrigued and I want to try this brand. It's like one of the brands I want to try. The next I have the Rare Beauty weightless eyeshadow primer on my wish list. This is an eyeshadow primer, comes like in a wand and stuff, and I really want to try this. Like, I really do. Like, I love the idea of this, just like a nice wand to put like your eyeshadow primer on. I still believe in eyeshadow primer. I know some people believe in concealer, but I still believe in eyeshadow primer. I still think it works, so I want to try that one. And then I also have another Rare Beauty product on my wish list, which is the Stay Vulnerable Glossy Lip Balm in Nearly Rose, like a flushed pink. I just thought it sounded nice, like a gloss but kind of like lip balm concoction, and I'm into it. So next is the Rare Beauty by Selena Gomez Stay Vulnerable Melting Cream Blush. I've also had this on my wish list for a while. I'm just really into the brand, and I like how this comes in a compact. This is in Truly Mauve and stuff. I just like the idea of that, and I kind of want to try it. Then I also have a eye cream from the Inky List. This is a really affordable skincare brand from Sephora, and I'm also intrigued with their niacinamide serum, so I could potentially even try that. But this is their caffeine eye cream. I just like the idea of this, and it's on my loves list, and I kind of want it. So next is another product from Rare Beauty. Actually, I have a few more from Rare Beauty, and this is the With Gratitude Dewy Lip Balm in Nude Mauve. I just love the idea, and I've heard really good things about these. They also have their concealer on my wish list. I had the foundation, but I never bought the concealer and stuff, but I am kind of intrigued, so maybe I will buy this, maybe not. And then next I have the Patrick Ta Major Glow Lip Shine on my wish list. And she's an influencer, which is supposed to be a pink K pearl. These are like more metallic glosses, so I think they're gonna be good like toppers. But I'm also intrigued with Patrick Ta's like cream blushes. Like, he has like duos that are like the cream and then the powder. Really intrigued with those. I just don't have any on my wish list currently, but I'm very intrigued. And then next is the Bite Beauty Changemaker foundation. This has been on my wish list for I think over a year and stuff. I believe this might have been in my 2020 Sephora loves list, but still on my wish list. Will I buy it? Who knows, but I'm definitely intrigued. Next is the Fenty Beauty by Rihanna Gloss Bomb in Fenty Glow, which is a rosy nude. I am still intrigued with this. I'm really into like nude glosses, clearly. I'm still intrigued. I actually am wearing the Fenty Rihanna mascara today, and I really like it, but I want to try more Fenty. Like, that's one of the brands I want to try more of. I've only really tried their mascara, a sample of one of their foundations, but I haven't tried much, and I'm really into it. And then the last thing that's on my loves list is the Milk Makeup Cream Highlighter in Lit, which is a champagne pearl. This is like one of my go-tos. I panned this a couple years ago. I got it in like a subscription box and like quite a few years ago and stuff. I panned it in 2018, and this is out of stock, and I'm hoping it comes in stock because this is like one of my favorite cream highlighters, and the full size is an ounce, so I would preferably like the full size. I'm hoping this isn't like discontinued or something, but that is on my loves list, and I feel like my loves list is always expanding. So I'll definitely have to keep you updated in some way about it, but I'm happy that I finally filmed my loves list, and I can't wait to share it. Let me know what's on your loves list down below. I'd love to hear about it. And be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. I post videos trying every week. Life's been a little chaotic recently, honestly, so I'm working on it. But yeah, I hope you guys are having a great day, night, whenever you're watching this, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.